He's a single guy. Why wouldn't you have a bar in your living room? It's totally normal.
Hello, everybody, and welcome to the third house in my Sims 4 miniseries, A Typical Dutch Treat.
And here we are at house number 3. And you may already notice that this is quite different from the others. This is what we called in my stream that neighbor. Everybody who was in my stream knows exactly what I mean. But yeah, this is the neighbor that all of these people hate. These people like to have a very pretty garden, like super neat and everything. And then there's this neighbor who doesn't freaking care. Although that's how it seems. There's a little bit of a different story going on there, but yeah. He just doesn't do anything in his garden. It's just old and unkempt. And by the way, what I didn't mention is we have our mailboxes here, and that's why there is also no mailbox in this lot. If you actually want to download it and play with it, you'll have to put a mailbox yourself in it, because there is no mailbox at this point, because that's just not a thing that we usually do, like putting our mailbox outside separate from the house. So it's here in the door. I wish that that was usable in The Sims. Oh my god, I forgot to actually go to the right floor. I'm sorry. Is this the right floor? I think so. Yes. Okay, let's go inside. So again, we have a place for the coats and everything and an umbrella stand. This is a guy who lives alone. We thought about in stream. So that's why this is a little bit more simple. And there's the fuse box thing. We don't have to see that again. And there is the toilet again. He doesn't even have a toilet rug. Just nope. No toilet. A calendar, though. You know what a lot of people do in the Netherlands? They have all these sayings against the wall. Like, they're on a tile, and there's a written saying on it, and it's usually not a well, sometimes it's an actual saying, but sometimes it's just like a really funny tiny poem or something, and it's like or sarcastic or ironic or something, and they put it all around their walls. We don't have that in The Sims, so I couldn't really do that, but yeah, that's the thing that a lot of people do. So yeah, a little bit like cheaper wood flooring in this house. The cheapest floor that he could find. And it's not actual wood. It's like these laminated floorings, you know. We don't usually have actual wooden floors in rental houses. This just doesn't make sense. And this guy has a cat. Let's go inside. And there's some oldish wallpaper over here. We thought that maybe his grandma had lived here before and he just left things as it were. Or maybe someone else lived here and he moved in. But yeah, his grandma died. That's the story behind it. His grandma died, and some of the furniture is actually from his grandma, and some is from like thrift stores and everything, but he didn't buy anything new. Like, nothing in this house is new, as you can see. Let's go to the living room in this house first. Also, like, piles of paper stacked away behind the couch. Okay, well, this is new, though. But he built it himself, because we thought that this guy was actually does woodworking for a hobby. So he has a bar that he made himself. Because, you know, he's a single guy. Why wouldn't you have a bar in your living room? It's totally normal. Then there are all these family pictures. Never mind that these are all vampires. There's just no family picture collage thingy in The Sims. There isn't. At least not in my packs. Again, maybe in Parenthood or something. But in my packs, there's not. So yeah, they're all vampires. Deal with it. Yeah, lots of brown. This is literally what you can find in thrift stores over here. I don't know if it's the same where you live, but like, yeah. This table is, yeah, and these kind of couches and this furniture, it's, yeah. If you go to thrift stores, it's full with this. And we thought about this clock being from his grandmother, at least, and the chair is from his grandmother. And yeah. He took them. Also, like, these legs. I have furniture like this as well. A lot of people like to buy this and paint it white. I also do that. Like, you know, the shabby chic style. But yeah, not him though. He just left it brown and everything. His chairs don't even match, because he just had to buy whatever he could find. And maybe some are still from his grandma or something. But the others broke and he had to buy some new ones. So. For some reason, he has a different kitchen, even though this was probably a newly built house, so he probably would have a white kitchen. But if this was a very old house, then there could still be a very oldish kitchen in there. And that's why I chose this brown oldish kitchen, because this is like more old style Dutch. So I tried to incorporate that. He doesn't have a dishwasher. He has a very old fridge. Like maybe he even smokes because it's quite yellow. Yeah. And this, like, it looks like Delft's Blauw, which is a blue kind of like plates and stuff that we have over here, and this kind of look like it, so it feels really Dutch. And also like with this, like, yeah, like the boat and the watchtower and everything, so that's why I put that there. Let's go upstairs. No, let's not go upstairs, let's go into the backyard. So his backyard is completely overgrown. There is a statue that he got from his grandma. There's this very, very old plastic chair. Super cheap and not nice, but this is so standard. Yeah, it's like 1990 standard, you know? Not many people have this anymore, I think. But yeah, when I was a kid, everybody used to have that. Like I said, he likes woodworking, so there's lots of planks in the garden and everything from like old wood that he found. He has some laundry outside. And yeah, a small table here, like everything is overgrown. The only nice thing over here is this thing over here, which his barbecue is under. And that's because he built it himself. And I think this is like the first thing he puts in his yard to try to make it look nice. And I think he is planning to make his whole yard look nice at some point, and maybe even inside, like build his own furniture maybe. But he just didn't get that far yet, so this is the only thing, like, and the bar inside, you know. And then this he probably also got from his grandma, and he just put it there. Again, the ugly bin. For some reason he also has a spare tire. And then his shed is actually dedicated to his woodworking. That is his woodworking place. And he even has a little sign. I don't know why. Maybe he wants to sell it at some point as well. But yeah, let's go inside here. Let's see it a little bit from above, because then we can see a little bit better what he has. So what I thought was, he built all of this himself. And he put this stuff in here to make it look nice. And this was probably the first thing that he built, like this chair. Or wait, did I put that very ugly table in here? I don't know, but like, you know, this was it from his early days when he didn't really know how that worked and everything. And this is a little bit newer, as you can see. It looks way more fancier, and like the connections are nicer. This is probably also a little bit older, and like he kept it all there. Oh, but all of this is stuff that he built himself, and a lot of it is just kept here. Oh yeah, so this was probably his first table over here, like the crooked table. But at this point he's this good, like he can build stuff like this, you know, and maybe he does commissions, who knows. So that's his thing. Now let's go upstairs. And here we are, and right as you come upstairs, you see grandma. Meet grandma. This is grandma. Both the picture and the urn is grandma. And this is a thing that happens in the Netherlands a lot. People save the ashes of their loved ones inside their home. Not all of them. There are people who put it in a graveyard, or who like don't even put it in an urn, but they go to a place in nature and scatter the ashes there. That's totally a thing too. Some people just get buried and don't even get cremated, but a lot of people get cremated, and like it's allowed, at least here, to keep the ashes in your house. And I know that it's not the case in a lot of countries. In some countries, that's even illegal. But yeah, he has his grandma over here in the hallway. And it's the first thing you see when you get upstairs, which is a little bit weird. But I don't know what the crack was about. There was probably a story behind that, but there is a crack. Because it's like, yeah, he's not really good at renovating and then keeping his house neat. But yeah, about not keeping his house neat, he doesn't really have a nice hamper. He has this, and like his clothes are everywhere, and nobody knows what is clean and what is dirty. He also has this shower, not a bath like the previous one, and he does have a shower mat, but that's just because this rug was already there. Like, he got this rug from his grandma and he just decided to put it in the shower. So that's why there's a very old-fashioned rug in here. And also these old-fashioned lamps and everything. Yeah, he, like, either from his grandma or the thrift store, like I said. Like, not everything is from his grandma. But again, this very old-fashioned wallpaper, because he just didn't feel like tearing it all down and painting his house all over again. He was like, no, it's fine. It's still good. You know, why should I? And we will see why in just a sec. Let's go to this room, which is his master bedroom, which is not the biggest room in the house. That's because he uses it for something else. But yeah, he chose a smaller bedroom as his bedroom. He has a small TV over there in the corner on a very old cabinet. He has a very cheap wardrobe there, a very old lamp, and two non-matching lamps because, well, thrift store, you know? When do you find matching stuff? So this lamp over here, we call it a Tiffany lamp. I don't know if that's like a world, like if that's what it's called all over the world. But we call it a Tiffany lamp, and it's a very old-fashioned Dutch kind of lamp. I don't know if it's typically Dutch, but a lot of Dutch people use it. At least, and thrift stores are full of it. That's basically it. It might not be typically Dutch, but using it is. And then there's the other small room over here, which is basically his... Well, a lot of people use the attic for this, but, well, we cannot really put stuff in the attic, so I didn't do that. But this is basically his spare room in which he just dumps all his crap. So there we go. This is actually usable. I didn't put anything around the bed, so if you want to play with your Sims here, they can actually sleep here. But I wouldn't advise it, because look at this. There's... So I thought that this was the room in which he just... put all the stuff that he still got from his grandma, which he didn't really find a use for, but he also didn't want to throw it out because it meant a lot to his grandma, you know, stuff like that. And I think that this is his first camera, and that has meaning to him. In a short while, we will see why. This was his very first camera, maybe given by his grandma even, or maybe by his dad or something. I don't know, but he held on to it for all this time, because it meant a lot to him. And then there's all these garden gnomes. I'm just thinking, like, his grandmother had all these gnomes and stuff in the garden, and he was like, yeah, the statue is fine, the rooster is fine, but all the gnomes have to go. And then there's some boxes and, like, an old pot which was broken and, you know, stuff like that. So, yeah. But again, there has to be a bed, because when guests come, they need to sleep somewhere. So this is basically his guest room, and because nobody ever comes here to sleep, he just put all his crap in there as well. But there's still the bed. And then we go to the biggest room of the house, which is in all the other houses the master bedroom, but in his house. And now we see why he has all this cheap stuff. It's not because he doesn't care. It's because all his money... Well, it's a little bit because he doesn't care, but it's like, he's not poor or anything, but his money goes to streaming. This guy is a streamer. And look at all these computers. Oh my god, it's like a streamer's dream. But yeah, he has this streamer computer. I had to put more computers in here because you cannot play games on your streaming computer, which is kind of weird because most streamers use their streams to game. But, well, he's not a streamer per se, he's a content creator, because like, he has this camera over here. He has this camera over here, so he does stream, but he also creates videos, probably. Like, he has a drone, so he has all of it. Like, he has studio lighting. Look at this. He has a green screen attached, like, so I wanted this to look like a green screen is in front of the wall, instead of, like, the actual wall. I could have just put a wall in front of it. That was just standing there. I'm only now thinking of that, though, so I'm sorry. But yeah, this is his streamer room, and isn't it amazing? I want this room. Yeah, so that's why he doesn't care about getting new furniture or buying plants for the garden, because that shit is expensive. He is like, no, I put all my money where my stream is, and I put all my money in YouTube, and I'm just gonna be the best content creator out there. So that's this guy, or that guy, like we called him in the stream. And then we go to the fourth house,
but we will do that in the next video. It's already up on my channel, just follow the link in my description and it will take you there. And there you can also find the other videos of this series in case you missed them. I hope you liked this video. If you did, give it a like and follow me for more Sims content. And let me know in the comments what you thought of this house. I see you in my next video. Have a lovely, amazing day and stay twinkly.